Hey my friends, a little bit breezy here today, hopefully you can hear me, because this is an important topic. This is about removing the weeds from your mind so that you can plant a beautiful garden that blossoms. What the heck am I talking about? Have I lost my mind? No. In fact, I'm about to be taking a lot more control of my mind, which is a great thing. So, did you know that we have 60,000 thoughts a day? And 60,000, I mean, what the heck, our minds are working overtime. And most of those are negative. Which is really sad, because life is meant to be lived, and we should always be thinking about how we want to live it to the full. And if we wake up in the morning and we're already worrying about things, we have doubts, we have fears, we have criticisms, we think of things that went wrong the other day, we've got relationships we're thinking about, people that are bothering us, frustrations, anger, resentment, all these things, and that's what we wake up with. We don't wake up with the truest vision of how we want to turn up in the world and live our life. And I've noticed for myself, for sure, I have been letting the weeds grow in the garden that is my mind. And by that, I mean, if you think about every single negative thought as a weed and how quickly weeds can grow and cover everything and take over all the gorgeous plants and flowers, your mind gets pretty disrupted, right? It's just full of weeds, it's full of confusion, there's no focus, there's no vision there, and you're allowing the weeds to dominate everything you think, and they're smothering your hopes and dreams. So I've been listening to a fantastic book called The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari by Robin Sharma, and it's a beautiful, basic, simple philosophies around reclaiming control of your mind, and instead thinking about what you do want to have happen in your life and focusing on that. And why that's really important is your mind does not actually know the difference between a real thought, hi runner, and something that you are envisioning. So your mind has an incredible visual component. If you close your eyes each morning and meditate and are fully present on the vision of how you want to live your life, that is actually what your mind believes to be true. So you can imagine your future self right now as if it's happening, and guess what, your mind starts to believe that is the reality, and that is actually the future that you tend towards, and it becomes true a lot more quickly than you think about. So if you are what you think, then surely it is far preferable to be thinking about the best possible version of you and the life that you want, because the more you think about that and the more you feel it and connect it with your heart, your mind, your soul, the more likely that is actually to become your true reality. Everything starts to shift in you. The universe starts to answer. Your vibe and your body, the energy that you're putting out is starting to radiate that. You know when you meet those people and they just feel like they're on cloud nine, they're high on life, they're living on purpose? It's because they are. It's because they see their vision and hold it so strongly and live it every day that their vision has actually become their reality, and that's how they operate and behave. And as a result of that, every single thing in their life starts to compound and come true and make that reality their daily life. So they have no doubts, no fears, well, not that they have none, but they are highly able to control their mind with exactly what they want to be thinking about and push themselves towards that greater vision versus focusing on the past, on the negative thoughts, on the things that you did wrong, on the things that might have been, because they're all in the past. But if every single morning we wake up to think about the past, guess what? Our past suddenly becomes our reality today. So we're stuck in a freaking endless cycle of crap, and we need to interrupt it. How? What I was mentioning just before, and Joe Dispenza, a fantastic minor transformation expert, talks about, is meditation. So being very present with yourself, aligning yourself, closing your eyes, sitting still, taming the beast, as he kind of likes to call it, getting it to sit for a moment, 5 minutes, 10 minutes more, breathing and envisioning that future vision, and continuing to focus when your thoughts shift and go to the negative or distract you, to bring it back to that vision and just being there in the here and now. I'm going to drop the link to his video below because it's fantastic. I'll also drop the link to the book. I hope you can still hear me. And this is something that I've realized I have not been doing a great job of. I've been gardening at home, pulling out the weeds, planting some new beautiful roses and gorgeous dahlias and all these lovely flowers that blossom and make me happy every single time I look at them. But I've been not paying as much attention to my mind, and the weeds have been growing pretty thick and strong. It's time time to rip them out, replant what I want in there, and make this garden blossom. So I hope that you can do the same. Definitely watch the links to that video, and I'll be sharing more on this in future videos. Oh, and this was day 11. 11! Lucky 11 angel numbers of the 29-day video challenge. I'm Natalie Sisson.